Hello YouTube and welcome to the fourth video tutorial about Timmy and Anatella. I am Frank van den Bergen, the CEO of Timmy. In the previous videos, we learned how to import data and how to use the raw filter box and the calculator box from Anatella. Let's now go back to our main example. To remind you, the objective was to plot a small bar chart here that illustrates the different education levels of the women population in the United States. To do so, our Anatella graph will be composed of these five little boxes. We already have the first two boxes. Let's now add the other boxes. Let's go back to Anatella. So we'll restart from the graph that we created in the previous session. To open this graph, go to your working directory and double-click your tuto.anatella file. As you can see, I already cleaned it a little. So let's now drag and drop inside our Anatella graph a new aggregate box. So the box is inside the transformation standard category, and this is the aggregate box. The objective of this aggregate box is to compute all the different values contained inside the column education. So I'll click on add group by variable and education. And then I run the box. And then it fails. Oh, I really hate when Anatella just annoys me like that. So it stopped with an error inside the log window. And if you can't find the log window, it's just usually below the data table window, just there. So what's the message inside the log window? Anatella is telling me that it cannot compute the aggregation, and it's suggesting me two different solutions here. One and two. Each solution has its advantages and disadvantages. The most common solution is just the first one, here. This solution is named the InRAM algorithm. All you have to do to use this solution is to tick the little checkbox just there. And then you can run the aggregate. The only downside of this InRAM algorithm is that it won't always work on really big data problems. This is because it's an InRAM algorithm, and thus it's limited to the size of your RAM, of your memory. On this example, the output table has only 17 rows. So this is a very small table, and it easily fits inside the RAM of your computer, and we won't have any problem. On the other side, if the output table there has a few million rows, then it might be better to use the orthogon solution. To check if you are reaching the limits of the RAM available on your machine, you can have a look at the log window here. And you have the peak memory consumption always visible. It really tells you how much RAM memory you used during the last runs of Anatella. Actually, 99% of the time, you can just always check the checkbox there, and it will be just fine. The other option is mostly here because Anatella is built from the very beginning to manipulate tables with hundreds of billions of rows, and we couldn't handle such large volume with a simple in-RAM or in-memory algorithm. By the way, this is one of the nicest features of Anatella. Anatella is not an in-memory tool. The in-memory tools are limited by the RAM memory of your computer. With Anatella, there are actually no limits to the size of the data that you can process. The only real limit is the capacity of your drive, simply. It means that with Anatella, you'll never be stuck because the data is too big to fit into your limited RAM. This is in opposition to other tools that work in memory. The other most well-known in-memory tools are Python, R, and Spark. This last one, Spark, is actually the most surprising for me. I was really not expecting Spark to be an in-memory tool, because this means that, in this case, Spark is just limited to the very small data volume that fits into your RAM memory. And this is in opposition with the people's belief that Spark is a tool to manipulate really big data. But since Spark is actually an in-memory tool, it's actually very limited in terms of data volume compared to Anatella. On the other side, since we really like R and Python, we try to bypass the in-memory limitation of these languages. This means that we added inside the R and Python engine, included inside Anatella, some unique functionalities, a multi-threaded streaming mode, that removes the size limitation of these two languages. This was difficult to do, and we are the only one to propose you this functionality, unlimited data volume with R and Python. If you want more information about the integration of R and Python inside Anatella, there is a dedicated video about this subject. The link to this other video is inside the description below. As a parenthesis, for the technical coders among you, you might want to know that this InRAM algorithm is actually building a large hash table in memory, while the second solution is able to compute all the aggregates that you want, using only the amount of memory required to store one row of data. So it's practically nothing, just a cool achievement. So the output table here of this aggregate box has only one column, and it doesn't contain any counts. So let's fix that. So I'll just tick the little checkbox here and run the aggregate again. And now I have the little count. Now you can pause the video, add the aggregate box, configure it, run it. Finally, you should obtain a table like this one. Okay, now we have all the data required to display our little bar chart. Let's add to Anatella the histogram box. So we go to R visualization, which is just here. And the first box is the histogram box. Okay. And we run the box. Okay. And we get a pretty ugly bar chart. Everything is scrambled. We'll see later how we can improve this chart. But for now, pause the video, add the histogram box, and run it. One way to improve the bar chart is to sort the table used as input. So let's drag and drop a new sort box inside our graph. The sort box is just there, inside the transformation panel, inside the standard category. Now there is a little trick here. If I drop the sort box with the tip of my mouse just there, at the exact position of the black line, then Anatella reconnects the arrow properly, and the sort box is directly inserted into the two other boxes. This is a very handy trick. Let's see what's happening if I don't drop the sort box exactly at the right position, a little bit too low, and you see it's not reconnecting. It's not as nice. So let's sort the table based on the column count. So I'll double click here, click add column on which to sort, click refresh from pin, double click count, okay, double click here, select numerical order increasing, and I run the histogram. Yes, as you can see, this is much better to look at. Now pause the video, add the sort box, configure it, and rerun the histogram box to get your bar chart. If at some point while working on your example, Anatella stops displaying the bar chart, this is normal and expected. If this happens to you, don't panic. Just unpause the video, and in the following, I'll give you all the explanation required to understand why this is happening. Welcome back, YouTubers. Now, I want you to close all your bar chart window. If you have already no bar chart window visible, that's even better. To close all the bar chart window, you can click as usual the top right corner of each window, or you can also click on the Kill R button just there. This will close all the bar chart window in just one mouse click. Don't do that while Anatella is running, because it will kill all the R engine and stops all computation. So now, just pause the video and close all the bar chart windows. Now let's try to display once again our bar chart plot. If everything worked as expected, none of you is able to get this display again. If you want, you can pause the video and try to make the bar chart window appear again, but it's very unlikely that you manage to do that. At this point, you should be slightly worried that your bar chart window does not appear anymore. And I'll do a terrible cliffhanger. I won't give you now all the explanation on why your bar chart is not showing anymore. You'll have to watch the next section of this video tutorial to understand why. Or at least you don't have to wait 1 week to know the answer. You can just click here. In the meantime, congratulations on learning how to use the aggregate box, the sort box, and the histogram box. You can now proceed to the next section of this tutorial. To do so, click here. See you!